It's been a while. While I was away on vacation, there was a lot that happened in the nuclear news. But fear not, your friendly nuclear physicist is back to talk about everything that has to do with the release of the tritiated water from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant into the ocean. We're going to go into how this water was produced in the first place and why are they releasing it into the ocean, how radioactive it is, and finally compare it with some daily measurements of radioactivity that we get from things that we pretty much do in our daily life. Without further ado, let's get into it. In 2011, when the tsunami caused the second worst nuclear accident in the world in Fukushima Daiichi in Japan, there was a reactor that basically exploded. For this reactor to be cooled down, there was water that was used in order for it to cool down, which was pumped inside the core and then taken out and stored outside in storage tanks. This water, of course, came in contact with fuel. Therefore, it is contaminated. There is a lot of radioactive materials in it that prohibit it from being released into the environment. This water has now been sitting for a while in these storage tanks and has undergone a process which is called ALPS. You might hear about the ALPS water in the news. And this is basically stands for Advanced Liquid Processing System. And what this means is basically that most of the radioactive elements in this water have been removed. I say most because this water contains tritium. What is tritium? Tritium is basically a hydrogen atom with two excess neutrons. It behaves exactly like hydrogen chemically. Basically, if hydrogen is in a water form, then tritium can also be in a water form, acting in exactly the same way. Therefore, chemically and technologically, it is very hard to separate it from common water. Hence, it is very hard to remove it from this contaminated water that we are discussing about. And now the whole work has been done in order to conclude as to if it is safe to release this water into the ocean, regardless of the fact that the tritium exists in there, even though the rest of the radioactive materials have been removed. Coming up to a question that people might have as to why should we release it in the first place is the fact that since the whole power plant is now under decommissioning and they are in the process of cleaning up everything and restoring the whole city in a sense so it can be again repopulated and perhaps the units can be restarted or something else can be constructed in that region, this water has to be removed from the area regardless. At the moment, there is, as we said, radioactive materials that have been treated and removed from that water. However, the tons and tons of liters of this water that is sitting there has to be somehow treated. So there was a few propositions as to evaporating it or releasing it into the ocean. And Japan, with external authorities, decided to release it into the ocean since it's a very big tank of water and the tritium that is existing in the tritiated water from the Fukushima is a very small amount compared to the one that is already existing naturally in the ocean. But let's talk a little bit more, what does this small amount means? Like how much is small, how much is little, and how does that affect us, right? So tritium, as we already mentioned, is an isotope of hydrogen with two excess neutrons, which makes it unstable. Tritium, therefore, is radioactive and decays into helium by releasing beta radiation. We have already explained that there is three major types of radiations, and beta is the one that doesn't really penetrate very far, only a few millimeters is how much it can travel. And particularly for tritium, this beta radiation is very weak. We know that from just by existing on planet Earth, we get annual radiation of around 2 millisieverts, total dose, and to that contributes food, space, the air, and the underground radiation as well. Putting that into perspective, tritium has approximately 10,000 times less radiation impact on our body than potassium does. Potassium is a naturally found radioactive element that exists in foods such as bananas that we consume on a daily basis. Therefore, this element is much, much less radioactive than potassium is, which already doesn't harm us in the concentrations that we have it in our body. Another important thing to mention is the fact that the release from the Japanese power plant will happen over a time span of 30 years. The reason why they're doing it is because by diluting the tritium in this tritiated water that they have on site and releasing it gradually into the ocean, no noticeable increase in tritium, hence radioactivity, will be detected anywhere, since, as we said, the ocean is such a huge water tank that this amount of water, even though it sounds like a big number, will not have an effect on serious health issues for humans or animals on site or around the world. Putting that into perspective, the amount of radioactivity that will be released from this tritium into the ocean over the 30 years time span in total will be approximately 50 times less than what China is releasing annually, and orders of magnitude less than what France and other countries worldwide are releasing in the ocean every year. Since tritium is an element that is produced inside nuclear reactors, hence when the water is circulating for cooling under normal operations, this water also ends up in streams such as lakes, waters and rivers, and ends up on Earth as well. Naturally, this is a process that happens all the time, every day in nuclear power plants, and these levels are still not significant enough to rise the radioactivity levels in that region or worldwide. Hence, it is nice and important to understand and nice to put in perspective what these numbers are. Maybe by themselves they sound like a lot, but when you compare them with other things that are already a common practice worldwide, you understand that the number is not really that big. Another interesting schematic to discuss as well is how this water will in total affect the human body, and the concentration of all the tritium that exists in the water that will be released over 30 years. If we compare with daily activities such as flying from New York to Tokyo, which can have up to 1 millisievert of dose to a human body, or taking a CT scan, which is even higher, or a dental x-ray, which is around 0.1 millisievert, then a dose that we will receive from the tritium from that ocean is estimated to be around 200 times less than a dental x-ray. All in all, in my opinion, it is a good approach, the one that Japan has chosen in close collaboration with the International Atomic Energy Agency, in order to release this water into the ocean. Yet again, there can be better communication to the public in order to explain what exactly that is and how it is done. It exists in the TEPCO website, which is a company that deals with the nuclear power plants in Japan. However, I could say that it could have been a little bit more open or worldwidely available to the people in order to try and avoid this fear, a lot of misconceptions, or way too many creators and public speakers saying their opinion about the topic and the release of the water instead of the actual facts. However, I do think it is a sound and valid approach, and the numbers do show that this is not going to harm the people of the area or the people anywhere worldwide. So of course, things as banning seafood from Japan, like China has done, it is a little bit of an exaggerated move, more so perhaps for the public eye, not so factual when it comes to China, especially releasing more than 50 times of that dose just in 1 year of what Japan is trying to release in 30. So it goes to show that there needs to be a little bit of scouting between the news in order to get the actual information, but here we are. And I hope this video helped you understand a little bit more what is going on. I would love to answer any further questions you have about the tritiated water release from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Leave them in the comments down below and let me know what you think, and if you want me to discuss any other news that are happening in the nuclear world at the moment or have happened before. Don't forget to like and subscribe and turn on the bell notification icon. It's been Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and until next time, see you soon!